Eternal in heavens. For in this we grow. grown, earnestly desiring to be clothed upon with our house, which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Now he that has brought us in the selfsame thing is God, who has given us unto the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. 8 verse says, we are confident, I say, and willing that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. You may be seated. My text for today is, there's no place like home. Hallelujah. There's no place like home. When I was preparing this, I was thinking, you know, maybe I should talk to the siblings and see, you know, what kind of sister was she. But they can't nobody tell it like you can tell it. Because you lived it. I can't even imagine. And I was thinking about talking to the children and saying, what type of mother would she be? But the thing is, nobody will understand and know like you know. But I do know her as grandma. And I do know that every place grandma was a home. Yes. Home is defined as a place where you can live, learn, and live, learn, and be happy. Yes. I know one thing is that I don't care what happened at our natural, at our houses. We ain't had to go but too far because we always had a place to stay. Amen. We can cut up and tear our whole house up, but we can just drive down all the creeper. And there you know that grandma was going to have a door open for you. And that's one of the things I loved about her, is that no matter what was going on in your life, that she was willing to be there for you. She was willing to speak a word. One of the things I love about grandma is her name is Dorothy. And so I just started to research that. What does the name Dorothy mean? Okay. I went and I looked, because I like to look up stuff, and because, you know, I'm a nerd on occasion, and I like to look up stuff. And it says Dorothy means, in English, a gift of God. I looked at it again and I said, what do you mean a gift of God? Because, you know, this gift from God is different from a gift of God. So, the English language, I don't know too much about him, so I went and looked it up, and there's a difference between being of something and being from something. It says when you are talking about materials that are used to make something, you say that it's made of or made from those materials. Used made from when the original materials have been completely changed and cannot be recognized. Paper is made from wood. I'm going somewhere. Have not been completely changed, and you can still see them. A table made of wood. So I begin to think about Dorothy, a gift of God. I always wonder why, when you got around grandma, you had to change the way you acted. Because since she was a gift of God, you saw God when you saw Dorothy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. She either drew you or she drove you, because you couldn't come in a presence with any and everything. You might have been cutting up outside the house, but as soon as you stepped across the threshold, all of a sudden what was in you, who you really was, started coming out. The She went down to Grandma House for 48 hours and was up and running like nothing had happened. Because there's something about being around the gift of God. See, there's healing in the presence of God. See, there's healing in the presence of God. So that's why we always try to get around Grandma. Because when we get around Grandma, we know we got around God. And the sad part is half of the time, we didn't know what we needed. But as soon as we walked in her presence, we got exactly what we needed. And Metric was taking it hard. Grandma came home, she's a pharmacist as well. I don't know if she went to school for it, it don't even matter. But she has had pills wrapped up in a napkin. And I knew couldn't do nothing with Metric. He just falling all to pieces. Grandma walked in the room, dropped something on him, he woke up by time for the funeral. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. She had a way. In the doctor's office. I remember saying, I want to go home. And when Grandma said, I want to go home, it ended all other conversations. All the doctors coming in talking all this, that, and the other. Grandma said, I want to go home. Now, the process of getting to home, she was so ready to go home. By the time we got all the paperwork, she had already got herself dressed and ready to go. And wondering, where's my transport? Fussing out everybody. And then before you can even think it, I used to walk into a room all the time and I would ask her just to lay her hands on me. Because I knew that gift of God. The gift of God. I went on to say that in the presence of God, there's something called a refuge and protection. Psalm 16:1 says, keep me safe, my God. For you I take refuge. We can go into a presence because
world. One thing Grandma did was she loved you all.
unconditional. You can come in a mess, but if you stay around with them long enough, that you have to change by and by. There was this story back in the day, I don't know if you know it, but there was this movie that went by it was called The Wizard of Oz. And there was this young woman named Dorothy. And Dorothy was a little girl that got lost from Kansas. She met, was the She gave us everything that we need to be great. The charge now for us, for her legacy to live on, is for us to either, if you ain't got it together, get it together. If you got it together, help somebody else get it together. Because Grandma always wanted her children, her whole family to be successful, for us to stay together, to love each other, to take care of each other. And that's all we're here left to do. In order to honor this gift of God, we have to remember where the gift came from. And what Grandma talked about more than anything in the world, and I could hear every day, she just say, thank you, Jesus. That in the midst of everything that she's going through, and she can go out and say, thank you, Jesus. Yeah. The least that we can do is go out and live a life that she will be proud of. Yes. We thank you. We honor you. God bless you. There's no place.